average speed and average velocity concept chuddam. Body has started at point A and traveled to point E, and it is traveling different distances at different periods of time. But since the motion is in a straight line lo unna motion anta kuda distance will be equal to displacement. Straight line in one direction anamata. And time consumed is, here it is t1 and here it is t2, t3 and t4. And the velocities are, here the average speed will be total distance traveled by total time taken, which is nothing but, here the total distance, which is represented as s1, s2, s3, s4, which can also be written as d1, d2, d3, d4, is nothing but s1 to s4 sum and by, divided by t1 to t4 sum. Whereas here it would be v1 plus v2 plus v3 by v4, and total number of velocities are 4. Therefore, it would be 4. If there are only 2 velocities, it would be v1 plus v2 by 2. So that is the difference between average velocity and average speed. You should not be confused while doing the numericals. So herein we get the answer to the question number 2 of page 102, wherein it asks, under what conditions is the magnitude of average velocity of an object equals to its average speed? The answer is quite simple. As long as the body is moving in a fixed direction along a straight line, there is no change in the value of distance and displacement. They are one and the same, and therefore speed will be equal to velocity, average speed. That is the only scenario where the speed and velocity magnitudes are in total agreement, because there is no change in direction. Whenever there is a change in direction, obviously velocity changes. There is no doubt about it. Therefore, as long as it is in a straight line in the same direction, there is no change in velocity. It agrees with the speed.